So guys, this is Shivani Sengar. I worked as an internet click company. In today's video, I will discuss what is human trafficking. So start with introduction. Human trafficking is one of the most heinous forms of organized crime and violation of human rights all over the world. There is a strong concern on the rising trend and multidimensional nature of this criminal phenomenon, which victimizes men, women and children. Traffickers take into account neither border laws nor national prejudices. The objective of human trafficking is profit. Whether through abduction or deception, they deceive desperate and ignorant people whose dream of being freed from poverty is transformed into the worst of nightmares. Trafficking assaults human dignity, flagrantly violates fundamental rights and erodes conscience, thus fomenting corruption, undermines international security and development, and creates vast revenues for organized crime. The global economic crisis has resulted in a spike in this phenomenon in the form of forced labor, whereby the victim himself accepts this situation due to lack of substantial choices and ways out of poverty. It is important to understand the various types of human trafficking prevailing in the world. Trafficking in children involves the recruitment, transfer, transportation of receipt of children for the purpose of exploitation. Trafficking in women for sexual exploitations affects every region in the world. Victims are often provided with false promises of decent employment and are transported to the other country to be forced into sexual slavery. A forced marriage qualifies as a form of human trafficking if a woman is sent abroad and forced into the marriage and then repeatedly compelled to engage in sexual conduct. Trafficking humans for the purpose of using their organs, particularly kidneys, is a rapidly growing field of criminal activity. In this, the consequences of human trafficking are most directly felt by those who are its victims. Trafficking usually involves prolonged and repeated trauma. In this, the victims are at great risk of HIV infection. On the other hand, there are economic consequences of human trafficking. The cost of crime of trafficking in person incorporates many elements, including the value of all resources devoted in its prevention, and also the treatment and support of victims and the prosecution and apprehension of offenders. In this, human trafficking has expanded to almost every state in India, especially in the state of Jharkhand. Human trafficking is widespread. Some southern states like Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka also lead in human trafficking. Delhi is the hotspot for illegal trade of young girls for domestic labor and forced marriage and prostitution. Children, especially young girls and women, mostly from northern east, are taken from their homes and sold in far away states of India for sexual exploitation and to work as bonded labor. Girls are forced to marry and more than one man in some states where female to male sex ratio is highly imbalanced. In this, new data released by Indian government shows that reports of human trafficking rose by 20% in 2016 against the previous year. National Crime Records Bureau said that there were 8,132 human trafficking cases last year against 6,877 2015, with highest number of cases reported in the state of West Bengal, followed by Rajasthan in the west. Even though a large number of efforts are being made in India as well as in the world against this crime, it is still prevailing in the society to a large extent. More efforts are needed to drive away this evil from the society at large. some stringent anti-trafficking laws and their right implementation is required. People should be educated on human trafficking issues and help the survivors to find security and happiness. That's all, guys. Thank you.